something that I have been mentioning is called cutoff cues. What it is the signals that dogs give when they want a situation, an interaction to be over with. And they're really, really subtle signals that a lot of dogs, because of being around a lot of things that just keep them enclosed or on a leash, they learn that these signals aren't very effective. So when they're really uncomfortable, they go straight to lunging, reacting, biting, and cut out all the in-between signals. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna really, really exaggerate our acknowledgement of her cutoff signals by having a dog come up to her kind of rudely. Instead of letting her stand there stiff and hoping that the other dog goes away, we're gonna show her what to do. She's used to not having the option to leave. We're gonna show her that she has the option to leave even when she's uncomfortable. If Daisy's gonna come straight towards Bella, and as soon as she gives a signal showing that she's uncomfortable, you're gonna turn and you're just gonna walk the other way. Some dogs, it'll be yawning, it'll be lip licking. Sometimes they're more obvious with the whale eyes. She doesn't really do that. Her signals are actually really obvious if you know what you're looking for. So what she does is she turns her head all the way away. So she'll stand there and let the other dog, let the person come straight up to her, but she'll be sitting there like this, like she's ignoring them. And she's trying to make it very, very clear that she's not interested. And she's used to that being ignored. So she goes really quickly to something else instead. So we're gonna show her, okay, you're uncomfortable. Leave on your own. You don't have to stand there and suffer through it. You see her turn her head to the side, lick lips, pant. As soon as she does any of those signals, you're just gonna turn and walk away. There, go, go. Good. Good. So that time she actually took a step back. Well, you can watch part two, which I will not be able to see, but when she gets up that close to her, the closed mouth. So I'm actually going to come now, I'm going to do a polite interaction, so I'm going to come do a curve and let them sniff each other. It probably will take her a second, and then she'll like, what are you doing still sniffing me here? Like, this is kind of a vulnerable spot, so she might show a signal, and we're going to move her out of that interaction. Go sniff, Daisy. Come on. Come on. There. Good. So she let her come right up and sniff her. I mean, which she would do it probably anyway because she knows this talk, but when she moved to her face, she did the turn, lip lick, and if we'd stayed there and let Daisy with her big metal mask on stay in her face, pushing and kind of licking and getting kind of intense, she might have snapped at her, and she would not have done it without warning. We would look at it and be like, oh, she didn't give any warning, but she gave a very, very clear warning. I saw it. Daisy might be a little bit rude and not care, but I saw it. She looked away and she licked her lip. She was like, I don't want to do anything. I don't want to mess with you. I want you to go away. I'm uncomfortable. So we're helping her out by showing her that we can respect that.